Oh, this guy's pretty good. And my opponent chose to play, which has become kind of unusual in this format. Most of the time, it seems that people want to draw. I don't know exactly why that is. I think someone just wrote an article on it, and everyone just follows it. But in this deck, I probably want to draw. I don't have any double green or double white, so I don't have a trying to play first. And you see, this person likes my articles. I don't know if you can actually read the chat in the video, but that's what he just said. So, thank you. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering, I bought a new mouse, so hopefully no more turbomagneting my own turbo magnet or killing my expansion router with itself. That one is dying. I could rest or I could clasp it. It's actually an interesting decision. Because if I clasp it, and he does my clasp, he's gonna have a 1/1 double strike probably, which is gonna be annoying. But if I arrest it, then he might just play a gigantic guy and I don't have anything to do. But I do have a revoke, and he does have a lot of planes in play. So, yeah, I think I'll just arrest you here. It's considerably better for my curve. And with clasp and carry on call, I can actually shrink a big guy too. Though it might be wrong, it might come back to haunt me. I really don't want him to like Divine Offerings or Revoke Existences and have a guy that actually blocks every single one of my creatures. Well, not every single one, but you get my point, I guess. It also lets me play Carrion Call on turn 4 instead of activating Clasp. And then Trigon on turn 5 instead of activating Clasp again. Yeah, I don't care about that guy. Here I'm just gonna play a Plains and pass. And when he attacks, I'm gonna block it for Carrion Call token. Assuming he'll attack, he probably should. Like, he's not gonna expect Carrion Call of all things against Green White, though he might expect Master's Call or Dispense Justice, because he doesn't even care about and choking teams. Here I'm just gonna block. I don't really want to race him with my hand. Even though I kind of could, since he has mana problems, but probably not. Alright, I just block here. Take away possible Metalcraft if he has it. And my opponent is actually not doing anything. Maybe it was better to just not block after all. That sucks. It's interesting that he would block, because at this point he doesn't know if I'm poison or not. And if I'm not poison, he definitely doesn't want to block here. So now he does have an artifact removal, he just kills a Trigon and whatever. He does not have a red light. Or that guy. Well, I'm gonna contagion that guy away. I thought I was gonna take the Trigon. Yeah, that's interesting. That's probably a lot better for him. It's not gonna matter because I'm gonna last minute change the rest. I should probably just do it on my turn. There's not much bad that could happen, but you never know. Yeah, killing the Relic Warder seems better than just killing the Crusader. You know, he does open it to the possibility of being killed later, the rest. So actually, at GP Denver, it's a very interesting play. The Louise had this learning relic porter guy, and as his only guy, and the opponent, it was stealing an arras, and his opponent attacked with a 4-4, and then he blocked, and the guy died, and the guy had to arras his own 4-4, because it's not optional. It's pretty cool. Yeah, that's not good for me. Oh well. Guess that works. I was considering whether I should play the Rustic and the Silver Replica, both. I generally don't like playing Silver Replica when I'm not gonna use it. Yeah, I would probably have just played the Rustic. Mountain, how lucky. At least right now I'm in a comfortable position because I already have six lands, so I can play mostly anything that I draw. And the late game is kind of where I want to be anyway. And that is not very threatening. Well, that might be. If he. Yeah, I'm not gonna play this. If he kills my Golem next turn, that's probably gonna be a problem, but. Maybe I should play the Scrap Melter, and I kill his token. Yeah, I should actually play the Scrap Melter. Well, that means I cannot give first strike to Cyberclaw Golem. But it's a lot better than if he kills my Golem. Because if he kills my Golem, he attacks me with the three guys. And I take 11. Because I'm not going to turn block with Rustic. This makes no sense. Oh, yeah, never mind. For a moment, I thought it gave plus one, plus one. So if he attacks, I can still turn block a guy with Rustic. And I'll take 7 damage, which is not good, but I can work with. So, which. Yeah, I think I'll just play. Oh, well, actually, I might play Silver Replica. Then I can block and kill the mirror. But that doesn't accomplish anything either. So, yeah, I guess I just play the Rustic and pass, and if he kills the Golem, I trade, and then I can play something else. That seems better than playing Scrap Melter and not having mana for first strike. If I did have two mountains, I'd definitely play a Scrap Melter. Because I have enough cards that deal with artifact hand. In fact, my entire hand. That I don't really care about wasting it to kill a guy and have a guy. Though hopefully he cannot kill my Golem, and that means he's not going to. He's taking a while to play, which hopefully means he can't kill my Golem. Because if he could, I imagine he would just do it on attack. Choking Fumes would be very sick in here. Never mind. Yeah, I'm dead. I'm gonna take 7 down to 7. I suppose it's not the end of the world. Hopefully he'll play a good artifact so I can kill it. And hopefully that doesn't cost me. Yeah, we're almost there. Here I sh yeah, I just play Scrap Melter, because if I play Replica, I'd have to trade, and Scrap Melter here is just better. And if he attacks, I'm gonna block. He probably attack, has no reason not to. Another? Yeah, I guess I'm dying. This sucks. Every time I always lose to like good artifacts and stuff. Well, now I have all those good artifact removal and I'm dying to tokens. My options are blocking the 3-1 and taking 4 down to 3, or blocking a 2-1 and taking 5 down to 2 but keeping my guy. I think that's better. Because next turn, I don't really want to play like Revoke Existence and Zero Replicant in his new tokens. I'd honestly rather just keep my guy, and he has a burn spell and. I mean, probably dead to a burn spell anyway, but if I block the 3-1, I might be dead if he doesn't have a burn spell. At least now I'm much better in the game. Of course, depending on what he does, please. Oh yeah, that, okay, I'm dead. That was a disappointing game. I just died out of nowhere. So I think clearly I won the 2-1-5s against him. They're probably very good. And I don't want maybe the Saber Claw Golem. And I guess the Blade of Opinions. I don't want to spend time equipping, especially his white red. So if I equip something on the fence, there are a lot of cards that could just kill this and destroy me. Yeah. I could play the Glinthawk. It's going to be very good to return a Mortar Pod and Magician Class, but other than that, I have a Mirror and a Spellbomb. Yeah, I just don't have a lot for return. And I'm just going to cut this Mountain for other planes because I added two white cards. And I really want to have the mana to play them. And now I cut the Golem. So this still leaves me three red sources, which is probably enough. And only one red card.